the Queen of the Night.
And what else is alive in the yard, gang?
Dandelion!
Yep, that's alive.
Chipmunk.
Definitely alive. And cute to boot. Oh, how about a rake? Let's see. Well, a rake doesn't need food and water and air to live and grow, so it's not a living thing, Hal.
Oh, okay. But you know what? It still gets a Hal hug. Come here, you.
Boom!
Flower alert! Flower alert!
Sweet jumping gerbils!
Well, what is it, Daze?
Tonight, the Queen of the Night cactus blooms!
No way! That's tonight? I can't believe it! That's so cool! Wait, who is this Queen of the Night we're talking about?
The Queen of the Night is a cactus that only blooms one night a year, and the flower only lasts for a few hours, and I've always wanted to go to the desert to see it!
But I didn't think anything could live in the desert!
Well, it looks like the Queen of the Night cactus does.
A flower that blooms in the desert? This I gotta see. To the desert! Tally-ho!
To the desert!
Hold on there, my excited amigos. Deserts are really dry and can be really hot. It's pretty harsh there. We had better prepare.
Prepare? How? You don't have like a song to sing about the preparation process, do you?
Funny you should ask, Hal. Hit it! If you're heading to the desert to see a flower queen, make sure that you bring some extra sunscreen. Come on, let me inspect. You need SPF to protect you when you're walking in the harsh, dry desert. Don't want to get stuck in a desert sand trap, so bring along a phone and a map. If you're lost, you'll get found while you're desert bound when you're walking in the harsh, dry desert. Make sure you don't burn, don't get hurt. Put on your boots and high socks, protect your feet on those walks when you're walking in the harsh, dry desert. To keep yourself warm, pack a sweatshirt, please, 'cause at night it can drop as much as 50 degrees. What's the reason the night gets freezing when you're walking in the harsh, dry desert? Before you hit the desert, before you go, make sure to pack plenty of that H2O. You need lots of water if you're a desert trotter when you're walking in the harsh, dry desert. When you're walking in the harsh, dry desert. All right, now we're ready. Let's go find that cactus. Onward and yonward.
Whoa. This desert is beautiful, Daisy, but so hot. I really don't see much life here.
Maybe if we look closer, we can spot more life here. Let's see. Oh, look over there in that burrow.
Hello.
Yowie!
Whoa, that was jumpalicious. How did you jump so high?
Well, ma'am, it's 'cause I'm a kangaroo rat. That's what we do. We hop.
Zounds! A kangaroo rat lives in the desert? Things that live in the desert. Kangaroo rat. So cool.
Hello, kangaroo rat. It's me, Hal the dog.
Hey, not that I don't enjoy a nice hug there, partner, but what are you doing out here in the desert?
We're looking for the Queen of the Night cactus. Tonight's the one night of the year that it blooms.
That sounds like rootin' tootin' desert fun, but where exactly is that cactus located?
Let me check my map. Says the first thing we have to do is turn right at the mesquite trees.
Mesquite tree? Mesquite beans are my favorite snack. Come on, I'll show you where they are. Hop this way. This here is the mesquite tree.
Oh, hello, mesquite tree. Oh, it's me, Hal.
The mesquite tree is alive in desert 2. Amazing! ! Scribble underline.
Yep, mesquite trees grow real nice and easy in dry places. And that's good, because they have dippity-doo-da delicious beans that I like to eat.
Oh, I want to try. Oh, mesquite-y. Say, who come you can put so many beans in your cheeks all at once?
It's cause we kangaroo rats have pouches in our cheeks to hold lots of seeds. It's how we collect enough food to survive here in the harsh desert.
Whoa, those are some big cheeks.
The sun is starting to go down, you guys. We have to get to the Queen of the Night cactus by nightfall. Thanks for getting us here, kangaroo rat.
Good luck, ma'am. Stay on the path and watch where you walk here in the harsh, dry desert.
We will!
Thanks!
And now I'm off to start my day. I mean night.
Yow!